Dear students, you are welcome to the knowledge series on fragmentation. In this slide, we will discuss about the fragmentation and the type of fragmentations. As the statement shows, as processes are loaded and removed from memory, that is secondary memory, to the primary memory, the free space is broken into small pieces or partitions. That means whenever the process which that is being saved in the secondary memory, from that secondary memory, when the process is being moved to the primary memory, immediately that particular space automatically is being broken down into small blocks or pieces. So what happens if you again return the same process or the data from the primary memory back to the secondary memory? It may or may not accommodate that particular space or that particular size of the data into the secondary memory. So this particular things or the this particular form of the memory management structures need to take into account how this particular blocks, once it is moved from the secondary to the primary or the primary to the secondary, is being allocated in appropriate space so that it can be later retrieved and can be processed by the CPU as per the need. It happens that after some time, process cannot be allocated to partition because of the small size and memory partitions remain unused. This problem is known as fragmentations. That is what I mean to say, that once it is being moved, that particular portions is remain unused because that particular process cannot able to occupy that space. So this problem is known as fragmentations. So here I have shown it has moved from here to here, and once this particular process is moved from here to here, then this shared portion is known as hit. That means the data has come, and suppose if this data is moved out and that space is being created, that is known as hole. So hit is indicating data retrieval and hole is indicating that data moving out of it. Fragmentation is the phenomena where a block or a partition or a hole of memory is wasted that cannot be used. Keep this one in the mind. Fragmentation is the phenomena where a block or a partition or a hole in the memory is wasted. We are talking fragmentation with respect to the loss or the waste that cannot be used. Now the fragmentation is divided into two parts: internal fragmentations as well as the external fragmentations. Now we will talk about the internal and external fragmentations. Now if you see across the internal and external fragmentations structures, I have shown one figure taken from the site for your understanding, is that this is our operating systems, this is the memory structures, where a one job or one process is occupying this space, job A, job C is occupying this space, job F it is occupying this space. Now you carefully watch here. This particular portions, the particular program is, or the process program is sitting. This place of the that particular process space is being occupied by information, data, or a program, whatever it may be. This space is occupied, that the shaded portion is occupied by the C, and unshaded portions or the spotted dots is the free waste, the portions which is not being used. This is the area which is termed as a free space. So this is an unused space, this is used for the job. So whichever the space which is being created that is unused, that is being treated as internal fragmentations. Or I can say that a memory block assigned to the process is bigger, and some portions of this memory is left unused as it cannot be used by the another process. So suppose as I told to you that this is unused and it cannot be used by the other process. So that's why this is known as internal fragmentation. I will talk more about it. External fragmentation, you see that this is the initial process was occupied this space, but this was not used. Here this was not used. So this unused space, here this is unused, this is unused, this is unused, and this is also unused. This is known as external fragmentations. So in the case of external fragmentations, total memory space is enough to satisfy the request. But to reside a process in it, as it is not a contiguous manner, so this particular process cannot be used in this space. So here you see this is after A, C is there, F is there, but it is not a contiguous or not in a sequential. There is a space is being created, so that this unused space is termed as a external fragmentations. So the internal fragmentations, when we talk about it talks about the memory block, but it is wasted. External fragmentation is that it's a memory block is used, but there is a space is unused space is being created. So that is known as external. So unused space, and this is the wastage of the block. For his further understanding of the internal fragmentation, there is another figure. Let's take an example. There is a program is written, and the program is A is there, program B is there, program C is there. Program A is 20 KB, so automatically you have to understand that when it is a 20 KB, that is you have to convert this one into the bits forms. So 2 to the power of that number of bits. So program A, program B, program C. Now this program A is 20 KB. It has to occupy the RAM memory, which is the primary memory. This particular RAM is having 4 blocks, 32 KB, 64 KB, 16 KB, and another some free partitions. Now this 20 KB is occupying this space, so automatically 32 minus 12 is 12 KB is unused space. Now 40 KB is there, this is a 64 KB, so 64 minus 40 is a 24 KB is unused space, the 40 KB is occupied. Now 16 KB is exactly occupied this block. So this unused space is called as a internal fragmentations. Whereas this is not an unused space, because this is a free partitions, whereas this is a unused space. So you should not get confused between this and this. This is a free partitions, this is unused. So this is known as internal fragmentations. Now external fragmentation, let's see these two figures. Now in this figure, a program A, B and C and D is shown. A is occupying 20 KB, so 20 KB is shown here. So it is occupying full. Now 40 is there, 40 is being shown here. 16 is there, 16 is there. So this is in a contiguous manner. Now comes the 80 KB. But here the free partition is 60. So 80 KB cannot able to occupy in this case. So this is the case of external fragmentations. Now another case, you let's see this one. Another is that now this program A is completed. So automatically this 20 KB is free from here. Now this program B is there, program C is there. Now program D is needed 80. So here it is a 20 KB and this is a 60 KB. But since it is this 20 and 60 is in a two different location and it is not a contiguous, so that's why this is a case of external fragmentations. I have given when a memory, in the case of internal fragment, when the memory allocated to the process is slightly larger than the memory size of the process, this creates a free space. See, when the memory allocated is slightly larger than the memory size, that means the process size is smaller to memory size, then automatically it will create a free space left unused in the allocated block or partitions. This unused space cannot be used by the another process, causing an internal fragmentation. That means, suppose if it is a 100 KB process, some secondary memory, it has to move to the primary memory, and this is a 160 KB, this 100 will occupy here. So this is a 40 KB, 60 KB will be, this is not 40, this is 60 KB will be waste. So this cannot be used by the another process, because this block is fixed. This structure, it's a fixed, so you cannot make it further segmentations. It occurs in a fixed partition allocation, that is what I mean to say, where partitions of a fixed size allocated to requesting process, waste portions cannot be used, that is known as internal fragmentation. Now coming to the external fragmentations, if total memory is scattered and non-contiguous, that is, you are splitting in a non-contiguous way into small piece, and request from the memory is not satisfied, although the sum of the available memory is fragment is larger than the request amount of a memory of process, is the external fragmentations. That means, suppose if 100 KB, 100 K is needed, 60 is there, 50 K is there. But this can able to meet the need of this process. But since it is not a contiguous, then it is a case of external fragmentations. It occurs in a dynamic and variable size partitions. So because of the dynamisms of memories. Now, how will you solve this external fragmentation issues? Now, external fragmentation issues, if you want to solve, the method is known as compactions. It can be solved by using a compaction. Compaction is a process in which the free space is collected in a large memory block partitions to make some space available for the other process. That means, let us take this example, operating system is there, program 5, program 4, program 3 is there in the main memory. And this 10K, 15K, and 50K, this is the free space. Is available. So, because since it is external fragmentation, it's not a waste, it's a free space. So what the operating system will do, when you go for a defragmentation, it will make all this P5, P4, P3 to one side. Operating system P5, P4, P3, and this free space is being summed together, so it becomes 75. So when next time when you save it, automatically it will, automatically this space is further being used for the allocations of the whatever the process is moved from the secondary memory to the main memory. By compaction, the contiguous block is made. The problem of a compaction involves shifting of a memory from one place to another reallocation. This is done by input-output operation, and hence reduce the CPU utilizations and efficiency of the systems. So automatically it reduces the CPU utilization and efficiency, because the whole process is to be restructured again, the search methods and identifying the location has to restart. So these are the basic points related to the fragmentation, and this is one of the important segments of the university's question papers.